Hello friends, today we are going to see electromagnetic interference in RF circuits. This is for the subject of RF design, module number 5. Introduction. EMI, the tolerance of the circuits and the components to all the sources of interfering electromagnetic energy. Also, EMI, also called as radio frequency interference, when in the radio frequency spectrum there is a disturbance generated by an external source that affects an electrical circuit by electromagnetic induction, electrostatic coupling, or conduction. The disturbance may degrade the performance of circuit or even stop it from functioning. What are the different sources of EMI in circuits? Local oscillators, switches, motors, filters, relays, circuit breakers, logic and digital circuits are the different sources of EMI in the circuits. Let's see how EMI sounds. EMI sound example 1 is showing a GSM mobile phone signal interferes with a speaker system. EMI sound example 2 shows a Wi-Fi signal interferes with the speaker system. Third, electromagnetic interference in analog TV signal. This signal can be seen and heard on this wikipedia.org in the above link. As our lives become filled with technology, the likelihood of electromagnetic interference increases. Every lamp dimmer, garage door opener, or other new technical toy contributes to the electrical noise around us. Many of these devices also listen to that growing noise and may react unpredictably to their electronic neighbors, including armature radio transmitters. Now we are going to see the types of electromagnetic interference. Electrical devices are capable of creating emissions that can interfere with the external environment. These emissions have potential to interfere with the electrical grid and other local electrical devices. There are two main types of emissions: conducted and radiated emissions. What is conducted emission? Conducted emissions are electromagnetic energy created by device and transmitted in the form of electric current through its power cord. This can potentially cause problems since power cords are connected to the entire power distribution network. Radiated emissions. Radiated emissions are electromagnetic energy created by a device and released as electromagnetic fields that propagates through air away from the device. Electric devices that create radiated emissions have the potential to interfere with other nearby electrical products. Let's see the features of conducted emission, conducted EMI and radiated EMI, and also distinguish between them. So there are four basic EMC, that is electromagnetic compatibility subproblems: A, radiated emission; B, radiated susceptibility; C, conducted emissions; D, conducted susceptibility. In A, you can check that there is a noisy component surrounded by the main component. which are connected with the same power cord. B, there is potentially susceptible equipment which have its own noise because of which the other component is also get affected. C, noisy component internally sends the noise to the other devices or to the power cord. D, potentially susceptible component will receive the noise from the equipment. So all these conducted EMI and radiated EMI and their features can be seen by seeing this diagram. Now let us go further in deep. What are the EMI types? One of the EMI types is based upon it, how it was created. Last slide we have seen some of the EMI sounds example. Now, how the way it was created, there are two types of EMI. Man-made EMI, naturally occurring EMI. Man-made EMI, this type of EMI arises from other electronic circuits. Although some EMI can arise from switching of large currents, etc. Naturally occurring EMI, this type of EMI can arise from many sources which are in nature, such as cosmic rays as well as lightning and other atmospheric type of noise that all contribute. Type of EMI based on its duration. There are two types of EMI based on its duration: continuous interference and impulse noise. In continuous interference type of EMI, a source such as circuit that is emitting continuous signal. However, background noise which is continuous may be created in a number of ways, either man-made or naturally occurring. Impulse noise. As its name indicates, this type of EMI may be man-made or naturally occurring. Lightning, ESD and switching system all contribute to the impulse noise, which is a form of EMI. Third type of EMI based upon their bandwidth. Narrowband EMI and broadband EMI. In narrowband EMI, typically this form of EMI is likely to be a single carrier source, possibly generated by an oscillator of some form. Broadband EMI, there are many forms of broadband noise which can be experienced, and it can arise from a great variety of sources. Man-made broadband interference can arise from sources such as arc welders, where the spark is continuously generated. Sun and its sun outs for satellite television is the example for broadband, when the sun appears behind the satellite and noise can mask the wanted satellite signal. Fortunately, these episodes only last for a few minutes. What are the major elements of electromagnetic? That is, what are the major elements of an EMI? First is source, receptor, coupling. Source also as an emitter. It emits or produces the emission. It may be noisy component or a transmitter. Receptor also as a victim is a component or device that receives noise or interference from the source. Coupling path transfers the emission energy to a receptor where it is processed, resulting in either desired or undesired behavior. What are the elements of an interference? There are many elements of an interference. First of all, what is an antenna? In radio engineering, an antenna is an interface between radio waves propagating through space and electric currents moving in the metal conductor used with a transmitter or a receiver. Diagram shows different types of antenna used in the telecommunication. Antenna like dipole antenna, aperture antenna, traveling antenna, Yagi-Ugi antenna, monopole antenna, microstrip antenna. Electromagnetic coupling. Now, let us see what is this electromagnetic coupling. Electromagnetic coupling is also known as transformer action. When current flows in an energized conductor, it produces an electromagnetic field at right angles to the conductor. In AC power system, electric current flowing in the conductor changes direction 120 times per second for a 60 Hz, 100 times per second to a 50 Hz system. Thus, electromagnetic field surrounding the energized conductor is constantly expanding and contracting. What are the EMI coupling methods? Here is the list of coupling methods. First is inductive coupling, capacitive coupling, radiative coupling, conductive coupling. These are the EMI coupling methods. Examples of electromagnetic coupling between the two items of an equipment. Here, the diagram shows the equipment in a system. Equipment 1 and equipment 2. Equipment 1 is connected to equipment 2 via common main supply. That means the power is coming to this equipment 1 and equipment 2 via common main supply. As in the previous slide, we have seen there are three types of coupling. The fourth one is we are going to explain. Radiated coupling, conducted coupling, and inductive coupling. As one of the elements of this interference is antenna, which can be seen here with equipment 2. Equipment 1 is having the coupling of EMI in the type of radiation, in the type of conduction, and in the type of inductive coupling. Examples of significant sources of an internally generated EMI given in the table. There are different source or device and the electromagnetic disturbance. So, we can check these different devices or source of an electromagnetic disturbance and we can find from where it is generated. Like for example, we have RF oscillators. RF field and voltages are the electromagnetic disturbances that are found in this RF oscillator. SMPS, harmonics of the switching frequency, is another example. Equipment emission and electromagnetic susceptibility. Equipment emission is defined as the emission of an electromagnetic signal which are coming from the electrical or electronic equipment. Whereas electromagnetic susceptibility is the tolerance of the circuit and the components to all the sources of interfering electromagnetic energy. Let us see what we see in the previous slides of coupling types. What is radiated coupling? In this type of coupling, when the source and the victim are separated by a long distance, typically more than a wavelength, the source radiates the signal which may be wanted or unwanted, and the victim receives it in a way that disturbs its performance. So this is radiated coupling. What is inductive coupling? This coupling occurs when a varying magnetic field exists between two parallel conductors, including a change in the voltage along the receiving conductor, and it is also called as magnetic coupling. Let us see what is transient coupling. Electrical transients and other disturbances are induced in power lines as a result of natural electromagnetic phenomena and from the variety of equipment. Lightning can produce transients on power supply either by direct strike or by strike or nearby structure. How to reduce differential mode coupling? There are two categories for balanced line and for unbalanced line. For balanced line, use twisted wire pair, add single braided shield. For unbalanced line, select coaxial cable with lower transfer impedance. Let us see how to reduce common mode coupling. Reduce by ground loop area, reduce cable length, reduce average cable height, shield an entire susceptible area. So there are different ways to reduce this differential mode coupling and common mode coupling. EMI coupling mechanism. Now, this EMI coupling mechanism can be seen by seeing the diagram which is shown in this slide. There are many ways in which EMI can be coupled from source to the receiver. So here the source is given and victim is the receiver. And there are many ways by which it is get coupled. The EMI get coupled from the source to the receiver. Understanding which coupling method brings the interference to the receiver is the key to being able to address the problem. The desired and unintentional coupling of electromagnetic energy from one equipment called emitter to the equipment called receptor is the electromagnetic interference or EMI. The various methods of electromagnetic interference coupling between an emitter and a receptor are illustrated in this figure. There is a radiative EMI coupling, there is an inductive EMI coupling, and conductive EMI coupling. In radiative EMI coupling, you can check that the source is radiating some form of EMI to the victim, which is a receiver. In inductive coupling, this can be seen in from source to the its victim, whereas conductive type of EMI can be seen in terms of capacitive effect that is going from source to the victim. Radiation coupling. The radiation coupling between an emitter and a receptor results from a transfer of electromagnetic energy to a radiation path. Various types of radiation coupling are coupling of natural and similar electromagnetic environment to the receptor, such as power line. The power transmission line here acts as a receiving antenna. Coupling of electromagnetic energy from nearby equipment via direct radiation is the another type of radiation coupling. Now, what is conduction coupling? The conduction coupling between an emitter and a receptor occurs via direct conduction path between the emitter and a receptor occurs via a direct conduction path between the emitter and the receptor. Examples of conduction couplings are Interference can be carried by the power supply lines when emitter and the receptor operates from the same power supply line. For example, common main supply is a frequent source of conducted interference. Another example, interferences are also carried from emitter to the receptor by signal or control lines which are connected between the two. Common impedance coupling. Here, as we seen in the diagram, there is a common impedance coupling that can be seen. Common impedance coupling occurs when the currents from two different circuits flow through a common impedance. The ground current 1 and 2 both flow through the common ground impedance. As far as circuit 1 is concerned, it is its ground potential modulated by ground current flowing in the common ground impedance. Some noise therefore is coupled from circuit 2 to circuit 1 and vice versa through common ground impedance. What are the difference between EMI and EMC is the last point that we are going to see in this module. EMI, as it's an acronym for electromagnetic interference, and it's essentially a disturbance voltage emitted from many types of electronics that cause performance issues with the devices and the components such as printed circuit boards. While EMI occurs naturally from electrical discharges, it has become extremely prevalent in modern society due to widespread use of everything from high frequency radios and cell phones to household appliances such as garage door openers and toasters. Other primary sources of EMI include transformer, converters, power sources and motors. Now, let us see what is electromagnetic compatibility. EMC stands for electromagnetic compatibility and refers to the ability for a device or electronic system to tolerate disruptive electromagnetic radiation. Since almost every electronic emits a level of EMI to function properly, EMC relies on limiting the amount of produced while maintaining the optimum level of performance. So there is a straightway difference between EMI and EMC. Thank you.